excited about this. So it was December 2017 when Nishal and I were discussing and issues. So when Nishal was offering this role to me, IBP, I do have a background in S&OP, and then he said, this is one opportunity which I have for you. I was doing strategy execution role. When this looked like, okay, this is a challenging effort, because in the previous company when I hired S&OP, somewhere we really fell short was change management as well as executive development. This is something which is very, very important for my process for running S&OP. So, the first thing which I really wanted to emphasize, what I learned across my implementations of S&OP, was that this journey is enabled by change management and the patience. I really, thank Nishal here, on a common platform, the kind of patience has been shown by the organization. We are almost 15 months in the process now. We have progressed quite a lot. However, there is still a journey to go. Now we have made a platform where IBP can be really utilized. So what we did was, on the top of the slide, when you see that was IBP concept launch, we said we first fix our S&OP process. Then we go with automation, and then we go live. How do we really leverage the system? So three things. What we did was a bridge progression. That how do we cover all the units? So though right now we have decided to go with one business, which has got 3-4 plants under its flagship, but we thought that not only OFC business, OF business also have a lot of dependability. Let's merge these two, and the manual process we started running. So from December to March, we added 1, 2, 3 locations and 4 locations. And in mid, we had SAP IBP launch. That means now the automation journey and the journey manual are going together. And by March, means now, we are actually covering 6 locations in S&OP. We have proper cradle of S&OP. We have demand planning, then we go supply planning, and then we go in S&OP meetings. We raise real business concerns. We say this, look, this is how you are, far behind your business plan. This is where you are initially into the business plan. This region is doing good. This is not doing good. Basically, to enable executive decision making. Then, in terms of complexity progression, what we started was demand planning. Then we started with demand, supply, and raw material planning. Then we started order planning also. So, a lot of credit goes to my team, Shubham and Nimit, who are here. Shubham actually works as a demand planner and Nimit as supply planner. And believe me, both jobs are real tough and S&OP is easier. Both of these things are real tough. Done well with proper guidance by the organization, it is really easy. And now what we have also added is inventory planning to it. In terms of integration of people building teams, what we did was, first it was S&OP team which was built. We realized it's not enough because we do not have automated systems. There are a lot of systems which do not talk to each other. We really needed someone as an MIS person who could really give us what really do we take to executives. Else, the situation which was happening many times, we go into the meeting, the data was asked, we'll come back. We didn't have anything to flash immediately to executives, guys, what happens if? And that's where, the real catch comes. The moment you tell to executives, look, I'll come back to you. 3 days after, your priority might change, the executive priority might change. Thing is lost. And then you realize in the next cycle, this was asked. You go in hurry and, by that time, you almost have lost the relevance. And these are the real things which do happen in S&OP meetings. So after MIS, then we also thought, we have our ISO function, which is inside sales function, which is a separate bucket where orders are coming in. They are working separately. ISO and S&OP and MIS working separately, that's not working. Let's merge ISO. Now with prevalent set of bugs. It's not an easy thing to just tell a function, look, go merge in that function. This really requires change management. And this is where S&OP needs to be supported by executives. So that was basically the first thing which I really wanted to say. This is something which tells you about how did we started our journey of IBP and what are the steps. And it's basically saying that first we'll do demand and let's say S&OP implementation. We go stabilization and rollout. So first section is demand and S&OP. Second section is response and supply. And third is production scheduling. So this process what we are trying to make is not only at higher level you make things automated. The real power of IBP comes when you actually start from the bottom. Everything is you know kind of automated, is aggregated, and then is super aggregated and presented in a very executive, chewable fashion. We, you know, it's not what you see is might be just me telling you, oh, this is too much of thing here. I do not want to go in each and every segment. However, we have a very clear-cut calendar for our S&OP process. And this, though there are building blocks of demand planning, supply planning, executive meeting, pre-S&OP meeting, etc., there is a lot which goes into the preparation of these meetings. So it's the main thing which I really wanted to tell in this is that these blocks need not to own by S&OP. IBP, as Mr. told, is a way of business. It's the people who actually are responsible for that function are the ones who own that meeting. So the change which we are trying to bring in, for an example, if you see number 15, demand review meeting is owned by regional managers. That's where the real catch is. So if, let's say, S&OP owns forecast accuracy, well, demand manager sometimes might say that I bought this order, this was not there in forecast, or maybe I did a forecast, but order didn't come. The responsibility is shared now in between IBP as well as demand manager, IBP and sales function. Then second is supply planning. Another thing which is very important is serial number 21 and 22, where we say supply review meeting, which happens by, let's say, S&OP head. And then we go to operation head. Look, these are the challenges we have. We need to make certain decisions. So now what we are trying to do is we are not asking, we are just not merely throwing data to executives. We just say, look, this is the problem. Specific, these are five things we need to do to achieve this month's revenue target, or if we can overachieve it, please give us a decision. These are the decisions which we need. Now, there may be certain decisions which are made in that meeting. There may be something which we take to executives further. Where we see disagreements, there might be disagreements coming where I say, no, you have to make this much because my customer requires it. However, things might be limited by my capacity and I say, oh, it's not possible. Then we take it to executive meeting. And any time demand and supply imbalance things come in, the real insight comes in those executives. Because they say, okay, we will see demand sustainable. Is it sustainable? Do we do capex? Is the demand going down? What's happening? Are we able to utilize our capacity, etc.? Now, in this, there is one more thing. The whole cycle is planned, owned by you know different teams. So it's a teamwork. IBP is a teamwork. All of this becomes really music to the ears if it is supported by right and functional data. Otherwise, what happens in executive meetings, look, that data is not right, what your analysis might not be correct, and everything fell short of expectations. You feel like that you did pull whole month cycle to you know to your best, but then in a minute, your 1 month work is gone. And that is where what we need to do is, as Mohit said, we have IBP Center of Excellence, where we make certain people work only for data quality. And then, you know, we churn all this into that becomes really good. This is where, you know, I heard the first presentation by SAP, and you know, interoperability was the word which was used. And I would say this is perfect example we have for interoperability. We have Salesforce on the left top corner. We have Cable Builder, is one more system. We have IBP on top, key blocks, S&OP, supply and response. Then we have SAP ERP, we are also bringing production speed. Now, if we do not make the system talk to each other, everybody would be working in silo. So what we thought, how and who can help us make it? So imagine these three blocks not being there first, and only these blocks, everyone is working separately. With IBP integration, we are bringing everything from one, two, three places. And then we see the data in totality. That's where the real strength will come in my SMB. I mean, as a user, I really want to see the data. I do not want my executive to think better than me. I am the one who's planning. Let me go to him. I need these decisions, because that's where now this actually, you know, surpasses my, let's say, either limitations, or you say there is something which has to be collaboratively decided. Okay, so this was what we have been doing. What we have also realized during this, and maybe that is something for the forum, that, you know, I really wanted to share my experience while implementing this journey. Anticipation of team members. Let's say you go on this effort. What happens really is that, you know, as a team, we have regular business reporting, and we do have this massive effort coming. And it's not an easy effort, there are a lot of people who work on it. So anticipate the bandwidth in advance. That will be a real game changer. Because you do not want, let's say, your program dates to keep procrastinating. That may be cost to you, and that may be, you know, other business cost to you. Indispensable need of flawless data, definitely. Shared responsibility. So many times what happens, people say, okay, here is the order, get me the food, I'll eat it. IBP is co-creation. IBP is something you cannot just leave your partner and say, go figure out how you do it. You stand with him and say, I am there, this is my process. Customization is possible, yes and no. What are the best practices? How other companies are doing it? And we have seen in the last few months when I have been working with GitaCloud, has been lot of improvement which has come in our process. We really started thinking the way world thinks. Otherwise, one team, one industry, you know, you might be limited by thinking. That's where the best practices comes in. Phasing for linked initiatives. When you implement, let's say when you start on the journey of IP, there might be something other which might be parallelly running in, which might impact your program. This really did happen to us. There was one separate program was running in, and the output of the program was supposed to be the input of the program. We had to really manage that very well to ensure that things are happening on time. So sometimes linked initiatives might be a hurdle if those are not thought properly. And that is why what happens is that not only the SNOP act, you see things from transformation act, that what are other things which are really going in. And that's how you link all the initiatives. Robust structure of COE we have talked about. Having an aligned North Star. Why are we doing IBP? And that is something which everybody will have to have a buy-in in the organization. This is how we are doing IBP. These are the timelines. These are the possible risks, etc. Okay. Now, let's say the thing has been implemented, you rolled out, go live has happened. Definitely there would not be ideal case coming in front of you. We have, you know, we have implemented something instead of that things happening fine. No. We have to drive that adoption. And during driving of that adoption, what was very, very important for us is the buckets which I have put down is continuous engagement and training with the sales team is very, very important. Bring them upfront, early in the cycle. even when, let's say, systems in the concept stage, bring them, consult with them, what do you really want to see? That really matters. So when we started, let's say, working with GitaCloud, and GitaCloud started doing some people in our presence, and few things were which really were eye-opening, oh, this is what they really expect. It's easy to do, but we never thought. Make focus groups to be regional champions, maybe in sales to choose one or two person, help them out, build how they want to see the business. They really become spokesperson for you. They say, look, I can use the system, it's very good. And they go and, you know, discuss with other people. Anyhow, anywhere availability of IBP, and we know that IBP is accessible on mobile, on, you know, Apple and Excel. So that also is a very big factor of adoption. Now, other than continuous training and accessibility, we have taken two approaches, top-down adoption and bottom-up adoption. Top-down is display of the executive commitment, which is there, yes. Easy and clear process documentation. So what we are doing is really implementing every process after the document. This is still, you know, work in progress, but what we really want to do, my objective towards end of the day is that somebody comes in new, here is the book, this is how we run our business in this time. Strong change management, rewards and API mechanism to be considered, reward somebody who is doing good, reward him or manage it by API also. Bottom-up adoption, basically, you know, many times salesperson will come and they are really smart. Okay, they will come, what is in it for me? We need to satisfy them. This is what is there for you. It's not only they are giving me their forecast. I'm telling that now we are not actually dependent on people. That okay, give me this data, give me that data. You just log in, see what's there for you. And challenge the planning back. See, it can be a instance that planning knows everything. What is my demand? What's happening in the plant? How much is supplied? Which shipment has been delivered? Why do we make them independent? You go in IBP, see what's happening to you. And then things become real interesting. Then the real thing, real competition comes in. So ease of data access need to be displayed. Just saying that this will ease your business, that assurance helps a little. You need to showcase it. This is really happening now. When you're working with sales team, they say, oh, it's available on spot. I want to follow. And then, again, same point, focus on each champions, let them be your advocate in adoption. This is us, right, by the way. So in this we said, okay, I think it's, let's not over-optimize things. Let's keep phase one and phase two. We go with few KPIs, and only these KPIs are the ones which we will focus on. Let's keep others for wave two. There were a lot of things which were going in mind. Now we see that what can be, what is possible through the system. So, you know, in excitement, what might happen is that, okay, take everything. And then, you know, we might ourselves be confused. We said, this is what we monitor. We monitor the progress on it. That's basically the part of value tracking. Then we go to phase two and decide. So, this is what I wanted to cover.